When I was little, something went wrong with me, and everything switched. Even my parents. My new ones did not like me, so they left me. My foster parents did not like me either, so I was left at an orphanage. Some of my friends were better off, but many were left at the orphanage too. We loved each other. We stuck together until we were 18, when we were separated. The military took the boys, and the doctors took the girls. They probably do not remember the tree anymore. Soon, I will not remember either. But I hope you will remember. Remember for me. When the tree changed me, I was not scared. At first, I did not know what was wrong with me. When my eyes adjusted, I was in a field of special trees. I was reminded of a story my ma told me. Alice in Wonderland. This was my Wonderland. I held myself close and looked up. The trees looked like they ended. But above them, there were upside down trees, and above those, there were upright trees, like they were being reflected forever. The pattern repeated for as far as I could see. I looked down, and I thought I was on solid ground, but when I looked more closely, I was sitting on a thin, floating layer of dust. It smelled like baby powder. And through the dust, I could see the start of another tree. And below that one, there was another, and another, an infinity of trees. While I played with the dust, I heard distant footsteps. They grew louder and louder. Then there were bright flashes of light all around me. Out from these lights, hundreds of people ran out. One man came up to me and whispered, "The trees are not the trees." He had such sad, tired eyes. As he picked me up and put me on his shoulders, he said, "You could be her. Anyone could be her. I promise I will not leave." There was a bright flash, and we were in another field. He was sitting in front of me with his hand out. Another flash, and we were both running past through the woods. Another flash, and we were both lying on the ground, looking at infinity. Every few seconds, there was a flash, and we would be doing something else. Again. And again. And again, over and over and over, it would not stop. It felt like forever. Years of flashes. I was so angry at first. But soon, I had those sad, tired eyes of his too. We were so sad and tired. Every now and then we would flash to another layer of dust. Above or below, who knows. But we would always see the climbers. I think there were people who tried to climb the trees while they were flashed around. They were stretched and burnt. Maybe the dust was the people that fell. The man was always with me. He kept me safe the whole time. It must have been years. It felt like 500 years. I named him Everett. He was always there. He never left me. Everett was my best friend. Then on one random day, no time, one random time, all the trees bent, and a flash brought me back to New York. All my friends were around me. Well, this was another New York. I did something wrong, and I lost Everett. I ruined everything. I should have stayed home that night. Why did I not stay home? I lost everything for me and my friends. I ruined their lives. I will not tell you about the orphanage. It was a hard time. I will keep memories of the orphanage to myself. They do not matter to you. When I was 18, I left the orphanage. I looked for my new parents. They were not together anymore. My new pa died from a broken heart, and my new ma lived all by herself. She did not let anyone into her house anymore. All because of me. I wanted my old parents back. I went to the Rockefeller Center for an answer. The tree stood at the top of the plaza, above everyone else. I was never supposed to visit again, but I did, and I spoke to her. At first, I could not understand her. Her voice was like a breeze behind my eyes. It was cold, and I could not move. But soon, I could understand. She said that I had to be ready to exchange one life for my own. She understood that I wanted to go back home, to my New York. She said, come back in 3 years. And I did. I waited. 1,095 days. I returned 3 years later. At first, I could not understand her. Her voice was like a breeze behind my eyes. It was cold, and I could not move. But eventually, I could understand. She said that I had to be ready to exchange one life for my own. She understood that I wanted to go back home, to my New York. She said, come back in 3 years. And I did. I waited. 1,095 days. I returned 3 years later. At first, I could not understand her. Her voice was like a breeze behind my eyes. It was cold, and I could not move. But eventually, I could understand. She said that I had to be ready to exchange one life for my own. She understood that I wanted to go back home, to my New York. She said, come back in 3 years. And I did. I waited 1,095 days. While I waited, I met a man. He was a very important man, a secret agent. He followed me everywhere. One day, I found him waiting inside my house. He told me that he was here to monitor me. No, to watch and protect me. But he had fallen in love with me. No one else liked me. So we took each other. We grew close. Leonard loved me. I loved him too. Together, we had a baby boy. I named him Everett. Little Everett was inside for 9 months when I saw the tree again. She put directions in my head. I followed those directions. I walked for 4 days. I had to. I wanted to go home so badly. But I became so happy when I could hear the music. It was like the tree's voice, but warm. The Washington Monument looked much bigger in person. Its door went up high, like it was for something much bigger. Then I went inside. There were bodies everywhere. The breeze told me to relax. I went on the elevator. It went up. All the way up. It stopped at the top, and the music blared. It was so loud I could not move. The floor opened, and I fell all the way down. I felt myself hit the ground. Then I kept drifting down, past the ground, past rock, sand, and magma, through the layers of earth. It must have been years. It felt like 500 years. Then I reached the other side, and I felt myself rising through all the layers of earth, past the magma, sand, and rock, past the ground, back into a body. Another body. Almost the same body. And flattened, like a little red pancake. But I felt so empty. My belly had sunk. Little Everett was not with me anymore. Many others laid around me, broken like me, almost alive and completely still. But little Everett was nowhere. While everyone else exchanged for their own lives themselves, I must have exchanged little Everett for mine. I cried. I cried for years. We all bled into the ground for years. Why did the tree keep us alive? Did they like pain? Did they drink our blood? Was there any reason for any of it? I lost little Everett. He had no say. He did not even say his first word. I ruined his life from the start. Maybe he lives in Wonderland. I hope he lives in Wonderland. One day, one random day, the music grew, and there was the brightest flash. We found ourselves outside, at the base of the tower. The tree had been freed, and we were in a field of trees. Wonderland had risen, but little Everett was still missing. We were all lifted out in helicopters. I was at the hospital faster than ever before. They told me it was 2003. They told me everything I knew was wrong. They told me everyone I knew was dead. And now they plan to fix me. I'm sorry, Pa. I'm sorry, Ma. I'm sorry, friends. I'm sorry, Leonard. I'm so Everett. Please remember me. Please, please remember me. Thank you.
song.